was a day. Would you read to me?
You hate that book.
I don't want to read either. Let's dance.
Renee April, our costume designer, I didn't envy her task to follow up the costumes in the first movie. They're so influential in fashion, but she really hit it out of the park.
Hello, hello, Aloy.
When you do a film with characters that are very, very specific in a very specific world, then 1930s or 40s or you know, now, you know exactly where you're going. This one, it's the future of the first Blade Runner. It's an alternate world. It's not our world. It's very hard to know where you're going with that.
The dead space between the stars.
Renee and Denis gave a lot of thought to the costumes because the costumes in the original movie were so iconic.
It's still one of my favorite movies. I don't know how many times I saw it. And that movie transcends the generation. It's not because you were there in the 80s that you love it. The young one, they love it.
As I was trying to inspire the costume department, the idea that what will be the fashion in the future, link with winter.
35, take two.
At the beginning, I did crazy costume, and it was wrong. I said, no. So the line is very, very narrow, where you can go, what is too much, what is not enough.
The main thing about the fashion of the new movie is that the fashion is like very expressive, but linked with surviving. And how they will incorporate survival gears in those clothes and making them like fashion statements.
There's no organic fabric, so it's all synthetic. So that puts certain limitations on you, but also gives you a lot of our opportunity to explore and be inventive.
I look for new fabric. We work a little bit with 3D and laser cut. It's new in the industry. It's hard to use, but it's fun. It's difficult for us in movie because our time is so short, but we explored with lights, fiber optic and LEDs, and I work a lot with plastic and fake fur, which I never work with. And that was really fun. To be a designer, you have to love your cast. And I do, I had the best cast. Brian is very aware of what he can wear and what he cannot, and he had to like it because he's wearing that coat for the whole picture.
The costume evolved, and it became something that really did help in the end, because initially it was very sleek and long and it was interesting, but it didn't necessarily say a lot about the world that they were living in. We made it much warmer and much more beat down and functional, almost as though you could tell the kind of harshness of this character's life just by looking at this jacket and what it had been through.
Everybody was going crazy over Ryan Gosling's coat. Even the women want the coat. And he looks so great in their long and the collars. Renee came up with this such beautiful architectural kind of clothing, simple but very beautiful.
Where is he?
Love is like a little boy. Sometimes she's a little girl, sometimes she's a woman.
The lines are very stiff and pure. There's no frill, there's no ruffle there. I want to concentrate on her extraordinary face. There's nothing that disturbs us from going to her.
What I like about this character is that she doesn't have to be sexy. She doesn't have to be the girlfriend. She doesn't have to be the mother. She doesn't have to be beautiful or loved. She can be a freak because she's made to be a killer woman.
The world that we did is so bleak and dark, and then we had those holograms, which was my candy. So I went crazy with the color. I used yellow, but bright yellow that I would never ever use. Feathers and bling bling and everything, overdone it. And it was so much fun.
Joy has all these different costume changes, like a hologram. So she got to be the 50s housewife and then more modern, this beautiful kind of springtime, beautiful dress.
Thank you.
Anna, my God, you can put anything on her.
Costumes in this movie, I gotta say, I don't even remember how many times I change my clothes in this movie. And it says a lot about my character because she doesn't need to do it, but it says how hard she's trying to keep it real for him, how much she's trying to please him and make him happy.
Denis sent me a sketch of the Doxy Barr costume, and I loved the coat. I couldn't even imagine it looking as good as the sketch. And then I showed up. I want to steal it. It's the most beautiful couture, like rain jacket, mohair creation. Renee blew me away. It made such a difference to getting in character, to have those costumes on and to have this world evoked through this mix of sex economy meets cold weather. I love it.
I think our costumes are very much in the spirit of Blade Runner. We've got really what we think is fashion that will be unique to our film the way it was in the first film.
It's not the story you get normally on a science fiction. It's way above, you know, what you expect.
A child can count to 9 on fingers. We should own the stars.